Getting the Windows cannot complete the extraction and Windows cannot open the folder errors. Here are four ways you can fix it. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Before we move forward, make sure to subscribe to our channel and like this video. It's free and helps us a lot. We do tons of research to find the working solutions for you. Your little support will help us continue making solution videos for you and others. Without further ado, let's jump right in. Method 1. Repairing the corrupted archive file. If you're experiencing this error while trying to extract or open a specific file, try repairing the corrupted archive file. In File Explorer, right-click on the file and select Extract or Open With if you're trying to open it directly. If you have a program like WinRAR or 7-Zip installed, you can choose the repair option which will attempt to fix any errors within the archive. Once the repair process is complete, try extracting or opening the file again. Method 2. Change the destination folder. Sometimes the error messages can occur if the destination folder you are trying to extract the files to has restricted permissions or a long path. Right-click on the archive file, select Extract or Open With. When the extraction window appears, browse and choose a new folder with a shorter path or different location. Try opening the file and check if the error occurs. Method 3. Check the file attributes. The next thing you need to do is check the file attributes and make sure they are correct. Right-click on the archive file and select Properties. In the General tab, look for the Security section. If you see an option that says this file came from another computer and might be blocked, click on Unblock and then Apply to remove any potential restrictions. Method 4. Enable Windows built-in extraction feature. Another thing you can try is enabling the Windows inbuilt extraction feature. Open the control panel, go to Programs. Click on Turn Windows Features On or Off. Scroll down and make sure that Windows Subsystem for Linux is checked. If it's not, enable it and click on OK to let Windows make the necessary changes. So that's it. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and troubleshooting guides. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.